we're obviously celebrating a good cause and a fantastic player here tonight. Can you talk, I guess, first about Danny and what makes him such a very special talent, deserving of this recognition?
So obviously Danny's one of the best players in his position in the world. He's been a top level player since, you know, as long as I can remember. I'm lucky enough to play with him now, and you know, you only see the quality through and through. And then I suppose on the night, it's just a brilliant night, massive for the charity. And you know, I came last year and it was an awesome time, and I'm sure tonight will be just the same.
Exciting time for rugby fans. We're starting to see those squad announcements. How have you felt about, I mean, particularly, you know, we've seen Ireland and Scotland and Wales starting to make decisions. How have you felt about some of those announcements and who we're going to be lining up against?
You know, obviously the Irish had an amazing autumn and won all their games, and the same for Wales. And then there's a lot of pressure on England as well, because the last Six Nations obviously underperforming. So I think all the squads are going to be fantastic again. They always are. And it's just on who's better prepared on the day and who performs, really. I think, you know, it'll be going from strength to strength with England. They came off the back of a strong autumn series, and then hopefully the boys can, you know, use that as a platform, and use last year's extra motivation in order to, you know, get better results hopefully this season.
I think obviously when Eddie came on board, there was this period of astonishing and unrelenting success. Do you think that a slight blip in that form might help the team to re-energise and refocus themselves this year?
I think it has done. You know, you saw the end of the South Africa tour, and throughout autumn, the team's rejuvenated, playing probably some of the best rugby they've played for a while. So, you know, coming into this Six Nations, hopefully it can only get better.
I think obviously there's been a lot of talk about fatigue this year because it is quite a hectic schedule. Do you think that's something that England have particularly the strength and depth at the moment to cope with?
Massively. You know, there's, you know, four or five players in every position that you can say put their hand up for a selection. So, you know, it's an embarrassment of riches, you might say, at the moment for Eddie. So, you know, either way, I think if even with injuries considered, England is still going to field an incredibly strong team.
The eternal debate amongst rugby fans about the northern-southern hemisphere divide, how do you feel we sit on that precipice at the moment? Because obviously it kind of comes and goes every year, and it's an evolving relationship, I guess.
You know, obviously the season structure's changing, things are changing to hopefully lessen that divide, but it's always, you know, slightly tougher for the northern hemisphere, I feel, having to, you know, have internationals alongside the main competition is tough, whereas obviously the southern hemisphere, the internationals are completely separate. So you know, it's hard to kind of switch concentration. You know, you're going from your club to your international duty. So you know, I think it's always going to be there, and there's always going to be that debate, but hopefully as the longer the time goes on, it will get better.
I guess my final question, on a personal level, what are you most excited about? What are you most looking forward to in 2019?
Well, first of all, I guess the England squad announcement's the thing I'm most worried about. We'll see what happens there, and then if I'm picked, hopefully getting a cap.